friends, today we are going to begin our half yearly portion. We have already completed taking chapters 1 to 9 for the periodical test. Hope you are thorough with the lessons. So today we shall begin chapter 10, that is verbs non-finite. What is the chapter's name? Verb non-finite. Okay, so there are two kinds of verb. What are the two kinds of verb? Finite verb and non-finite verb. There are two kinds of verb, that are one is finite verb and the other one is non-finite verb. Okay, so what is the finite verb? You can also open page number 91. So together we can read the definition which is given in your own textbook. Okay, finite verb works with the subject of a sentence to give a sense of completeness. So what is the finite verb? Finite verb works with the subject to give a sense of completeness. So we can say that finite verb give a sense of completeness into the sentence. Okay, finite verb give a sense of completeness in the sentences. So it also indicates a tense. How many tenses are there? Present tense, past tense and future tense. In the previous classes, we have learned that about the tense, no? And also persons. How many persons are there? Three persons. First person, second person and third person. And the numbers. Numbers, how many are there? Singular number and a plural number. Okay. It also indicate. It also indicate means the finite verb also indicate the tense, persons, number in a sentence. So we can say once again what is the definition of the finite verb. A finite verb works with the subject in a sentence to give a sense of completeness. It indicates the tense, present tense, the persons and the number in a sentence. That's the definition of the finite verb. Okay. Now we can read the given examples which is given in your textbook. I also have written some of the sentences on the board. Okay, the first one: Nidhi works hard to do well in the exam. Nidhi, here is the subject and the verb is, the finite verb is works. Okay, so the next one: She also helps others in understanding their assignment. She is the subject here and helps is the finite verb. Her friends often go to her to seek her help. Her is the subject here and go is the verb. So here are the sentences. We can look at your own textbook also. Here the verb. Which are the verb here? Works, helps, go. These are the verb have a definite tense. The verb here, which are the verb, works, help and go, it have a definite tense. Which tense it is here? Nidhi works. It is the present tense. She also helps. Helps is the present tense. Her friends often go. Go is here the verb. Which tense here? It is the present tense. Okay. So we can say the verb works, helps, go, and is a definite tense, and also it is they agree with the subject. With the subject, Nidhi, she are here the subject. So you can say that the verb agree with the subject in the sentence. So these are called a finite verb. So what is the finite verb here? A finite verb works with this in a sentence. It gives a complete sense in the sentence. So we can say all these sentences. Works agree with the subject, Nidhi. Helps agree with the subject, she. And go agree with the subject, her. So verb have a definite tense and also agree with the subject here. Now we will discuss about the non-finite verb. So finite verb we have completed. Now we will discuss about the next topic is a non-finite verb. What is a non-finite verb? Non-finite verb don't have any agreement with the subject. The previous we told that finite verb has a agreement with the subject. Okay, so here the non-finite verb don't have any agreement with the subject. That is, they are not limited as per the subject. It does not change as per tense, number, or a person. It has no change any. It does not change as per the tense, number, or a person. They don't perform any action in the sentence. So they don't perform. Which don't perform? The non-finite verb don't perform any action in the sentence. Let us understand with them one example. Okay. Here, Nidhi works hard to do well in the exam. Here, Nidhi is the subject. To do is the non-finite verb. She also helps others in understanding. ing form, verb plus ing form also we can say that it is a the verb ending with the ing is also known as a non-finite verb. Okay, so that we can hear understanding, it is a non-finite verb. The third example, her friends often go to her to seek her help. To seek here is a non-finite verb. So, we can say that non-finite verb cannot stand alone in a sentence. Not like a finite verb. Non-finite verb cannot stand alone in a sentence also. So, also we can say here the infinities. Page number 92. You can also open your page 92 page. Infinities. What's an infinitive? An infinitive is a non-finite verb that is preceded by two. Here also it is same, no? Non-finite verb and infinitives are same. Okay? So an infinitive is a non-finite verb. An infinitive is a non-finite verb that is preceded. Preceded means followed by two. We had heard two. For example, to do, to work, to go. The same as it is. Here also non-finite verb is preceded by to do, to seek, to go. Okay, these are the points you have to remember. Here the example which is given in your own textbook. Do you wish to eat your supper now? Do you wish to eat your supper now? To eat here what it is? Finite or non-finite verb? It is a non-finite. Okay, and also we can say it is an infinitives. To discuss, it is also a infinitives. Okay. So that's all students today. You will be going go through the chapter once again and understand it, read it. And next topic we will be taking it, bare infinities.